عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قلنا يا رسول الله هل نرى ربنا يوم القيامة؟ قال: هل تضارون في رؤية الشمس والقمر إذا كانت صحوا؟ قلنا: لا. قال: فإنكم لا تضارون في رؤية ربكم يومئذ إلا كما تضارون في رؤيتهما. ثم قال: ينادي مناد ليذهب كل قوم إلى ما كانوا يعبدون، فيذهب أصحاب الصليب مع صليبهم، وأصحاب الأوثان مع أوثانهم، وأصحاب كل آلهة مع آلهتهم، حتى يبقى من كان يعبد الله من بر أو فاجر وغبرات من أهل الكتاب. ثم
الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. We continue with حديث الصراط في كتاب الرقاق للإمام البخاري. Yesterday we spoke about the filtering of mankind, beginning with the al-kuffar, the disbelievers, mushrikeen, and those, they do not cross over that bridge. They do not. They go straight to hell. There is no need for them to cross over the bridge. So who crosses over the sirat? أهل التوحيد, the people of لا إله إلا الله, and of course those who are hiding amongst them, that would be the hypocrites. And yesterday we spoke about how the hypocrites will be also deceived, and they will be also thrown into the depth of hell. So we're left with the people of توحيد, the people of لا إله إلا الله. Like we say, إخوة, لا إله إلا الله does for us one of the following three things in the day of judgment. يعني نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نكون من أهل الأولى. One, you enter Jannah without reckoning, بدون حساب. تدخل الجنة بغير حساب ولا عذاب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrives at the land of gathering in a way that suits His Majesty, and then immediately those 70,000 and more, if you actually trace the hadith, you find them more than that, straight to Jannah. No حساب. Imagine this, I told you that story with Sheikh Osama before. I don't know if you heard it or not. Remember that story? Huh? Wallah, it's the first time I appreciate that how you enter Jannah without hisab. One Ramadan, Sheikh Osama was visiting us. He's coming, inshallah, this year, Dar al-Tawheed, inshallah, and also Abu Bakr, inshallah, will spread him around. So he was staying in an apartment in Dayton, you know, that side street from Abu Bakr. At Dhuhr time, I went to pick him up and bring him to the masjid. Of course, Sheikh Osama lives in the countryside. He's from my area. So it was his first year in America. فسبحان الله I am taking a right and of course the street is this way the opposite way so I have to look here so I'm not really paying attention to what's happening to my right I'm focused on watching the cars so this biker comes in very he's wearing headset I can tell that he maybe was smoking something and he just hit my car his bike just went into pieces and he fallen in the ground I was like driving like 2-3 miles I mean an hour very slow but his speed is what got to him so he fallen in the ground and he started acting up oh طبعا هو sitting next to me Sheikh Osama. So immediately, you know, I went down. So the people said, call 911. Okay, so we called 911. And you know how, when you call 911 here, then what happens? What comes first? Ambulance. And then what? Fire truck. And the police. And all of this is what? Of course, Sheikh Osama, for him to see this, I mean, over there, you get in an accident, you're lucky if they see you the following day. You know, when an accident happens, like in a country like Egypt, what happens? The people stop their cars and they go take care of business. And they even made it difficult on the people that the one who would transfer that person to a hospital, he would have to be interrogated. And they probably are going to accuse him of hitting him. So that's why the people are very hesitant. You know, we're going to help you as far as here. But taking you someone's place? No. Sheikh Osama sitting next to me when he saw this, you know, he said this to me. طب يا شيخ كريم بقى أنا هروح عشان أصلي الظهر بالناس. Sheikh Kareem, I have to go and lead الظهر. يا شيخ أسامة هذا فراق بيني وبينك ولا إيه اللي حصل يا شيخ أسامة هنجن يا شيخ أسامة والله يا إخوة I was sitting on the car and myself I didn't do anything I mean the guy just coming so I'm sitting in the car so the officer comes into me sir look how he spoke to me sir you need to stay in your car until the interrogator arrives. والله يا إخوة يعني أنا human being أنا بشر I can tell fear what started what man interrogator what's going on this is when I thought about الحساب in the day of judgment imagine being called to speak to Allah being questioned by Allah ما هو for you to appreciate the fact that people will enter Jannah without what Without a questioning. يعني السؤال, the questioning is not easy. Allah is asking you, did you do this? And why did you do it? Why did you spend this money this way? Entering Jannah without hisab. By the way, I got the permission of Sheikh Osama to narrate that story. And he's okay with it. Yeah. So the second thing that La ilaha illallah will do is what entering Jannah with hisab so the person would stand rakin and he would cross over the bridge but safely like the first group so yes standing for hisab questioning but his hasanat is more than his sayyat he will be admitted to to Jannah The third type, اللي هو يعني لعياذ بالله منه, اللي هم أهل الكبائر. Those are the people who will enter Jannah, but after حساب and after what? عذاب. Both. In Jahannam. And those are the people who will fall into hell from the top of that bridge. يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث أبي هريرة ومنهم المخردل That's a new wording that it's the first time I see it, المخردل, that these hooks will cut him into pieces. هذا هو المخردل. So that he would fall into hell. طبعا التوحيد will take the person out of hell. توحيد. There are four intercessions for the people of توحيد. شفاعة المؤمن للمؤمن, the intercession of the believer for the believer. شفاعة الأنبياء والرسل, the intercession of the prophets and the messengers. شفاعة الملائكة, the angels also will intercede. وشفاعة رب العالمين. To the extent, and this is by the way, this is how we respond to الخوارج. The ideology of الخوارج, يقول لك إيه مرتكب الكبيرة, the one who commits the major sin is خالد مخلد في النار, will stay in hell for eternity. This is one of the ahadith that we respond to them with. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the angels, أخرجوا, take out everyone who said لا إله إلا الله ولم يعمل خيرا قط. And he did not do any good. Imagine this. هو إيه بس عنده إيه؟ توحيد, بس توحيد ضعيف. Weak توحيد. He got engaged in what? In sins. لا إله إلا الله will certainly benefit you. ولذلك the scholars in explaining the second verse in Surah Al-Hijr, which says, رُبَمَا يَوَدُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْ كَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ. One day the disbelievers will wish that they said لا إله إلا الله in this world. So those who rejected لا إله إلا الله, they will wish one day they just said it. The scholars, they say, when will this happen? قالوا عند الموت. One narration that at the time of death. ودا يعني حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال ربي ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا. The second occasion, when they see hell. ولو ترى إذ وقفوا عند معاينة النار. ولو ترى إذ وقفوا على النار فقالوا يا ليتنا نرد. We wish we can go back to this world. But the one the consensus is when they are in hell. But why would they say this? Because they would see individuals who are in hell with them being called out, being taken out of hell. فَذِي will ask one another, why these guys are leaving us? How come they are not staying with us in hell? Oh, these guys said لا إله إلا الله in the dunya. Ah, wish we did say it. Wish we said it. طيب, hear this. حتى إذا فرغ الله من القضاء بين عباده وأراد أن يخرج من النار من أراد أن يخرج ممن كان يشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has finished the judgments among his slaves and he wants to take out of fire, out of the fire, whoever he wishes to take out from among those who used to testify لا إله إلا الله. شايف؟ طيب, أمر الملائكة أن يخرجوهم. Allah will command the angels to take them out. فيعرفونهم بعلامة آثار السجود. How will they recognize them? The spots of sujood. آثار السجود اللي هم, how many spots in your body when we prostrate? 7. The forehead and Watch it. The nose. The nose must touch. Two. The two hands. Three. I'm sorry. Five. The two knees. Seven. The toes facing the qibla. The feet, yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حرم على النار أن تأكل من ابن آدم أثر السجود. سبحان الله يا أخوة الله. شوف فضل السجود. The virtue of سجود. Allah made it unlawful for the fire to burn from the son of Adam the places on which he used to prostrate in this dunya. فيخرجونهم وقد امتحشوا. They will take them out. Anyone knows what is the meaning of امتحشوا? الامتحاش. ما هو الامتحاش? Like what? Burned out. That is true. Like الفحم. What الفحم means? Like coal. They are burned out like coal. Imagine this. فيصب عليهم ماء يقال له ماء الحياة. Then water will be poured on them. That water is called the water of what? Life. The water that gives a life. فينبتون نبات الحبة في حميل السيل. Look at the description. Water will be poured on them and they will spring out like a seed springs out on the bank of a rain water stream or a running water stream, I guess. A running water stream, right? A rain, actually, a rain water stream. You know, have you ever seen like the rain somewhere and or to the bank of a river or something and you see these things growing amongst the rocks? How they grow? So they will grow like this. Subhanallah, in another wording of this hadith, that they will be stamped in a certain way. That when they enter Jannah, the people of Jannah, they will say to one another, these are the people who just came out of what? Out of hell, and they did not do any good in their lives. طيب. We come to the story of the last man coming out of hell. This man will spend years in hell making dua. What he says, وَيَبْقَى رَجُلٌ مُقْبِلٌ بِوَجْهِهِ عَلَى النَّارِ فَيَقُولُ يَا رَبِّ قَدْ قَشَبَنِي رِيحُهَا وَأَحْرَقَنِي ذَكَاؤُهَا فَأَصْرِفْ وَجْهِي عَنْهَا. Oh Allah, الريح, that the smoke and the smell has killed me. I'm burned out from hell. Can you please take me out? Years. يدعو في الجن في النار. Making dua in hell. يا رب. يا منان. In another wording, when Allah wills, Allah will address him and he will say to him, if I take you out, if I give you your request, will you ask me anything else? No, that's it. That's all I want. I just want to get out of fire. الحديث يقول لك إيه؟ فيأخذ الله عليه المواثيق. Allah will establish a covenant with him. Okay, we have a deal. That's it. So he is taken out of the gates of hell. The hadith reads. Just out of hell. And he's left there. فيمكث هناك ما يشاء الله له أن يمكث. Allah will have him stay there for a while, as long as Allah wills for him to stay. and من الله سبحانه وتعالى will make him see a tree from a distance, شجرة. And when we say شجرة يا إخوة في الآخرة, the trunk is made out of gold. Add to this the shade is 100 years it would take a horse to cross or يعني run under beneath it. So when he see the tree, remember he made a vow, a promise that I'm not going to ask anything. He was going to start making dua, Ya Rab, bring me near that tree. Of course, in hill there is no what? Shade. Allah will ask him, haven't you had a confidence with me that you're not going to ask me anything? Look, ya ikhwa, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, well, Wallahu ya'adiruh. And Allah is giving him the excuse. It's very tempting. طيب, again another deal. If I take you under that tree to be shaded, will you ask me anything else? No. So he's brought underneath the tree. Yahwa, one of the most amazing things about this hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is simply in this hadith talking to the worst Muslim. Particularly, because this is the last man, what? This is what? Yani, look how Allah is talking to him. He's the last man coming out of hell, and the last man coming out of hell, and the last man entering what? Everybody's what? In Jannah now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him see another tree, but under this tree there is water. Imagine what they drink in hell. Huh? Boiling water. Again, he will make the same request. And Allah will give it to him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him see the gates of Jannah. Ya Rab, just, I don't want to enter Jannah, just the gates. Out of hell, then a tree without water, then a tree with water, then the gates of Jannah. So when he at the gates of Jannah, he sees inside what is going on. Ya Rab, enter Jannah, I don't want anything. Just enter Jannah. So he enters Jannah. And then he comes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and tells him, Ya Rab, everybody is thinking, I don't have anything. Everybody got his own house, his own thing. I don't have anything in there. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, go, enter, and you will have 10 times this world, this dunya. Imagine, this is the last man entering Jannah. He will have 10 times this world. Mulkuhu. With that, the scholars, they don't like that line. Afkhar rajul fil Jannah. The poorest man in Jannah will have 10 times this world. We will like, lamawdi'u sawtin fil Jannah. A distance which is occupied by a whip in Jannah. Khayrun min ad-dunya wa ma fiha. فهذا هو حديث الصراط يعني من أوله إلى آخره. This is حديث الصراط from the beginning until the end and what will happen. طبعا يا إخوة, like I said yesterday, that مشاهد يوم القيامة, the scenes of judgment day, were meant for us to prepare for. يعني they are not just to strike fear into our hearts or anxiety. Rather, a person strives to get ready for. And the message that the Sirat sends, and every scene, by the way, of the scenes of Judgment Day, sends a message. The message that the Sirat sends to us is steadfastness on the deen, being consistent. And I want to tell you, this is the most difficult thing about Islam, is being consistent. A lot of people, mashallah, at one stage in their lives, they attain al-Iman, but maintain it is the challenge. ولذلك, one of the companions, كما في صحيح الإمام مسلم, he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, قل لي في الإسلام قولا لا أسأل عنه أحدا بعدك. Tell me something in Islam or about Islam that I'm not to ask anyone else after you. At all. Like, tell me the essence, what should I do? I don't want a lot of details. Tell me something. You know what the Prophet said to him? Three words. He translated them, actually end up with more words. But in Arabic, قل, say, آمنت بالله, those are two, ثم استقل. Say, I believe in Allah, then be what? Be steadfast. هذا هو. قل آمنت بالله ثم استقل. This, ya ikhwa, benefits us, subhanAllah, immediately as we depart this world. Shuf, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُ. Indeed, those who said, رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ, our Lord is Allah, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُ, then they were steadfast. Look, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Angels would descend upon them. When? يقول ابن عباس, at the time of death. Imagine, at the time of death, you harvest the fruit of this, of al-Iman wal-Istiqama. Being a believer with steadfastness. You harvest this at the time of death. Imagine, angels will come at the time of death when a person is going through the agonies of death. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا. Fear not from what to come. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Grieve not over what you're leaving behind. Huh? أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. And then what? وَأَبْشِرُوا. Glad tidings. بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. But really, really, the ultimate or absolute fruit that you harvest of istiqama, of being steadfast on this religion, is on that bridge. Imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that some people will cross as speedy as katarf. Imagine that bridge. He's going to cross katarf. You know what the tarf is? What a tarf? هذا الطرف, the twinkling of the eye. وكالبرق, another type, كالبرق, like the thunder, the lightning, I'm sorry, وكالريح, like the wind, وكالطير, like the birds, وكأجاويد الخيل والركاب, horses and camels. شوف في حديث ابن مسعود عند مسلم, one man يمشي مرة ويكبو مرة. He walks for a while and then he falls and then he stands and then he crawls. يكبو يعني, what يكبو means? You know what يكبو means, right? يكبو, he walks in what? Crawling on the sirat. Imagine. To the extent that this man, you know, when he finally crosses, he looks back and he says, what? سبحان الذي نجاني منك. يعني, glorified and exalted, the one who saved me from you. Look at this. الحمد لله. Look what he's going to say. الحمد لله الذي أعطاني ما لم يعطي أحدا من الأولين والآخرين. All praise be to Allah that He given me what He has not given anybody from the first, yani of the human and the last.
He's thinking that this is a bounty. فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز. فالاستقامة is يعني is one of the and only patient people will do it. لأن الأمر the matter requires patience. A lot of us we lose track of الاستقامة because of what? Impatience. وذلك الصبر is a key for الاستقامة. Just to recap in the following 5 minutes, so inshallah we were ready for shuruq, inshallah. I mentioned 5 things that can help you to have istiqamah, to be steadfast. Number one, ya ikhwa, wallahi, and don't start anywhere else but this. الصدق. كن صادقا مع ربك. Be truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني you really want to be يا رب. لأن رب العالمين, listen, رب العالمين knows what you're thinking about. Don't pretend that you want to be مستقيم and meanwhile you have somewhat internal or inner reservations that you still, you know what, I want to be مستقيم but I'm still young and I want to just enjoy these couple of years but inshallah I want to... لا مستقيم. ما تضحك على ربك. Don't think that you can fake it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا. هذه number one. Number two, knowledge. العلم. العلم is one of the keys to استقامة. Because when you learn about such scenes of the Day of Judgment and the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all of this, it normally increases your iman, increases your certainty. And once your yaqeen increases, kicks up, your conviction, your commitment goes up. وذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ربط. What did he say? لَأَنَا أَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَأَشَدُّكُمْ لَهُ خَشْيَةً. I'm the most knowledgeable of Allah and I'm the most fearful of Allah. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء. Indeed, those who are knowledgeable of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the hereafter are the most fearful. Three, الصلاة لغة وشرعا. الصلاة. ورسول صلى الله عليه وسلم actually mentioned this in a hadith narrated by ثوبان رضي الله عنه, أخرجه ابن ماجه. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, استقيموا, be steadfast. Look at this. ولن تحصوا. The scholars say, what does it mean, ولن تحصوا? Basically, ولن تحصوا, if you translate it, you cannot count them. What does it mean, you cannot count them? The scholars, they say, ولن تحصوا أسباب الاستقامة. You cannot count the means that can help you be steadfast. Many. Many. If you want to just implement them, you can do them. Only a prophet, by the way, can fulfill these. Fasting day, break and fast another day, fasting Mondays and Thursdays, fasting 3 days out of the month, the 13th, the 14th, the 15th, praying tahajjud every night. Sadaqah. Jihad fi sabil, all type of things. Rasulullah sallam is telling you that if you want to count the means that can help you to be steadfast, you can't. But look at this now. Shall I direct you to one thing that can help you? Let's keep it simple. Look at this. وَعْلَمُوا, rest assured, أَنَّ خَيْرَ أَعْمَالِكُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. The best of the means is the salah. Scholars, they say, what is meant by the salah here? As-salatu lugha وشر. الصلاة لغة اللي هي الإيه؟ صلاة linguistic. The linguistic definition of الصلاة is what? What is the linguistic definition of الصلاة؟ الدعاء. الدعاء. خذ من أموالهم صدقة تطهرهم وتزكيهم بها. Take from their wealth the sinners. And the verse before it shows that those are people who mixed good and bad. So for them to repent, Allah is saying what to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam: خذ من أموالهم, take from their wealth صدقة, اللي هي الزكاة يعني, تطهرهم وتزكيهم بها, and do what وصل عليهم. صل عليهم means what? Make dua for them. وذلك السنة يا إخوة, whoever donates or whoever gives a sadaqah, the person should what? Make dua for them. اللهم ابن أبي 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 أوفى, when he brought wealth, he said, اللهم صل على آل أبي أوفى, هكذا. فالصلاة لغة اللي هي الدعاء, تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى. And there is دعاء in that context that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ثبت, it was established that every day he used to make what دعاء. Every day he used to make this dua, his wife reported this to us. I would hear the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making this dua every day. What dua? Ya muqallib al-qulub. Shuf, look at this dua. Oh Allah, you rotate hearts, change hearts. Thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. والصلاة اللي هي الايه؟ الشرع, five daily prayers. حتى في الصلاة الفريضة, يعني look at our صلاة that we perform every day, 17 ركعة, 17 times in the mandatory صلاة we make this دعاء. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. شوف. Guide us to the straight path. Keep us steadfast. This is what is meant, by the way. Because you're praying, you're guided initially. But what you're asking Allah to keep you up, not to go astray from that path. Number four and the one before last, يا إخوة, قصص الأنبياء. The stories of the prophets, the righteous before us. I'm telling you, this helps a lot. When you read about the messengers and the prophets and what they went through and how steadfast they were in the face of calamities, fitness. Subhanallah, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. يعني, if there is a companion, يا إخوة, who really went through fitan big time, was Ali. Allah, يا إخوة, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared him for this. يعني, subhanallah, the amount of trials he experienced at the end of his life. And Ali is, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever loves him, he loves me. Huh? And from early age, he was brought up by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We know that his father, Abu Talib, became poor at one stage, and his kids have to be distributed amongst the family, and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received Ali. وأول من أسلم من الشباب, the first to accept Islam from amongst the youth. Yeah. Imagine, when he was going through these fitan, whether it is the battle of Al-Jamal, the battle of Nahrawan against the Khawarij, the battle of Safin against the army of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. Huh? So the people would come and try to take him away from the right thing. He used to tell them that, what? وَلَا يَسْتَخِفَّنَّكَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Do not let those who do not have yaqeen, certainty, take you away from what? From the straight path. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يثبتنا يا رب العالمين. The last and the final, يا إخوة, is الصحبة, companionship. يعني we mentioned في خطبة الجمعة and we repeat it again that even if a person falls into hell, guess what? The believer with whom he used to hang around with in this world can intercede for him. You go back and you say to Allah, Ya Rab, my brother, he used to pray with me. He used to do all these a'mal with me. Look for righteous companionship because this will help us stay on the straight path, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. I hope we benefited from this hadith. And نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا إلى ما يحب ويرضى وأن يأخذ بنواصينا إلى البر والتقوى وأن يرزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل في السر والعلن. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله رب العالمين.
عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قلنا يا رسول الله هل نرى ربنا يوم القيامة؟ قال: هل تضارون في رؤية الشمس والقمر إذا كانت صحوا؟ قلنا: لا. قال: فإنكم لا تضارون في رؤية ربكم يومئذ إلا كما تضارون في رؤيتهما. ثم قال: ينادي مناد ليذهب كل قوم إلى ما كانوا يعبدون, فيذهب أصحاب الصليب مع صليبهم, وأصحاب الأوثان مع أوثانهم, وأصحاب كل آلهة مع آلهتهم, حتى يبقى من كان يعبد الله من بر أو فاجر وغبرات من أهل الكتاب. ثم يؤتى بجهنم تعرض كأنها سراب, فيقال لليهود: ما كنتم تعبدون؟ قالوا: كنا نعبد عزير بن الله. فيقال: كذبتم, لم يكن لله صاحبة ولا ولد, فما تريدون؟ قالوا: نريد أن تسقينا. فيقال: اشربوا. فيتساقطون في جهنم. ثم يقال للنصارى: ما كنتم تعبدون؟ فيقولون: كنا نعبد المسيح ابن الله. فيقال: كذبتم, لم يكن لله صاحبة ولا ولد, فما تريدون؟ فيقولون: نريد أن تسقينا. فيقال: اشربوا. فيتساقطون حتى يبقى من كان يعبد الله من بر أو فاجر. فيقال لهم: ما يحبسكم؟ وقد ذهب الناس. فيقولون: فارقناهم. فيقولون: فارقناهم ونحن أحوج منا إليه اليوم, وإنا سمعنا مناديا ينادي ليلحق كل قوم بما كانوا يعبدون. وإنما ننتظر ربنا. قال: فيأتيهم الجبار فيقول: أنا ربكم. فيقولون: أنت ربنا. فلا يكلمه إلا الأنبياء. فيقول: هل بينكم وبينه آية تعرفونها؟ فيقولون: الساق. فيكشف عن ساقه فيسجد له كل مؤمن, ويبقى من كان يسجد لله رياء وسمعة. فيذهب كيما يسجد فيعود ظهره طبقا واحدا. ثم يؤتى بالجسر فيجعل بين ظهري جهنم. قلنا: يا رسول الله, وما الجسر؟ قال: مدحضة مزلة عليه خطاطيف وكلاليب وحسكة مفلطحة لها شوكة عقيفاء تكون بنجد يقال لها السعدان. المؤمن عليها كالطرف وكالبرق وكالريح وكأجاويد الخيل والركاب. فناج مسلم وناج مخدوش ومكدوس في نار جهنم حتى يمر آخرهم يسحب سحبا. فما أنتم بأشد لي مناشدة في الحق، قد تبين لكم من المؤمن يومئذ للجبار. وإذا رأوا أنهم قد نجوا في إخوانهم يقولون ربنا إخواننا كانوا يصلون معنا ويصومون معنا ويعملون معنا. فيقول الله تعالى اذهبوا فمن وجدتم في قلبه مثقال دينار من إيمان فأخرجوه. ويحرم الله صورهم على النار فيأتونهم وبعضهم قد غاب في النار إلى قدمه وإلى أنصاف ساقيه. فيخرجون من عرفوا ثم يعودون فيقول اذهبوا فمن وجدتم في قلبه مثقال نصف دينار فأخرجوه. فيخرجون من عرفوا ثم يعودون فيقول اذهبوا فمن وجدتم في قلبه مثقال ذرة من إيمان فأخرجوه. فيخرجون من عرفوا. قال أبو سعيد فإن لم تصدقوني فقرأوا إن الله لا يظلم مثقال ذرة وإن تك حسنة يضاعفها. فيشفع النبيون والملائكة والمؤمنون فيقول الجبار بقيت شفاعتي. فيقبض قبضة من النار فيخرج أقواما قد امتحشوا. فيلقون في نهر بأفواه الجنة يقال له ماء الحياة. فينبتون في حافتيه كما تنبت الحبة في حميل السيل. قد رأيتموها إلى جانب الصخرة إلى جانب الشجرة، فما كان إلى الشمس منها كان أخضر، وما كان منها إلى الظل كان أبيض. فيخرجون كأنهم اللؤلؤ، فيجعل في رقابهم الخواتيم، فيدخلون الجنة، فيقول أهل الجنة هؤلاء عتقاء الرحمن أدخلهم الجنة بغير عمل عملوه ولا خير قدموه. فيقال لهم لكم ما رأيتم ومثله معه. رواه مسلم.